Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released iOS 17 Beta 5 to developers. I would expect iOS 17 Public Beta 3 in a day or so. Along with this, Apple also released iPadOS 17 Beta 5, WatchOS 10 Beta 5, macOS 14 Beta 5, tvOS and HomePodOS 17 Beta 5, and also a new AirPods Beta 3 update. So if you're running the betas on your AirPods, we now have a build of 6A5289C if you're updated. Now, as far as the overall size, this was 1.1 gigabytes on my 14 Pro Max and was about the same size on the iPad Pro as well and other devices. It did take some time to install though. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the build number and see what's new. So we'll go into settings, then we'll go down to general, then about. You can see the build number is 21A5303D. We're finally down to the letter D, getting closer and closer to a final release. We'll talk about when to expect that as well as beta 6 a little bit later. Now as far as what's new, the first thing is there is a new modem update on all the devices. From the 14 Pro to 14 Pro Max, it was updated to 2.08.01. Hopefully that continues to repair things with connectivity overall. Now, as far as the first new feature, there's an update in storage. If we go into settings and then we go to general, then iPhone storage, scroll down to the bottom, go to show all, and then scroll down again, keep going all the way down to the bottom of the storage, you have a new option for synced content. I don't have anything here currently, but you'll see it says media content synchronized from your computer. So that's updated. If you have a bunch of things synced for your computer, that will be here as well to give you the overall size. Within shortcuts, if we create a new automation under the automation tab, go to new automation and then create one based on arrival, departure, or something location based, go to arrive, we now have the option to run after confirmation or run immediately again. This was removed up until this point and it's finally been returned. So you'll see we have those new options on the right with beta 5. Also, if we go into health, they've updated this again. It seems they continually update this. And if we go into our state of mind and then log a new state of mind, the overall look is different again. They continue to refine this over and over. So log in emotion or mood has changed with some new graphics. Tap on next. And again, you'll see it's fairly similar, but slightly changed. So if I go through all of the different feelings here for pleasant, we'll go to next. We can describe how we feel. We'll just put excited. Tap next. And it says what's having the biggest impact. And we'll just say community, tap done. And it logs the overall emotion or feeling for the day. It looks slightly different. And of course you have reminders if you haven't set that up already. So that continues to be updated over and over. Now, if we go into our settings, this has been updated as well. So if we go back to settings and then we go down to accessibility. Under accessibility, they've updated some icons here. And you can see voice control on the left with beta 4, on the right with voice control on beta 5, there's a new icon. The same is true all the way at the bottom where we have assistive access. There's a new icon for that as well. So those have been updated. Apple could change these again. Also in the control center, they've updated an icon. The flashlight has been updated slightly. So on beta 4 on the left, you'll see it's a little bit thinner. On the right, it's slightly larger. It's a very small change and it hasn't been updated on the lock screen. They've also added a new little splash icon or little message if you go into the remote app. So if you go into remote and you go into this for the first time and it connects to a TV, you may see a little notice that you can locate your remote. This wasn't showing for me as I don't have an Apple TV in this room, but thanks to someone for sending this in on my Telegram channel. So you'll see locate your remote, find your paired Apple TV remote when it's nearby but out of sight. If you're adding a wallpaper, they've slightly reorganized this where on the left with beta 4, you'll see we have a different order than we do with beta 5 on the right, where we have weather, collections, and then Unity with beta 4. Now we have weather, collections, and astronomy. And it also shows a different filter over the top of the astronomy wallpaper. And if we slide over to the right, again, it's changed. So astronomy, color, and emoji, and instead we have Unity, emoji, and then color. Now also, if we go into Spotlight search and we search for a timer, and then we go to scroll down a little bit and then go to our shortcut to set a timer, we can now set it for longer than 24 hours. So we have hours and then we can change the duration to whatever we'd like and then set the timer for that. So we'll hit done and now it's counting down from 60 hours. So we have that option now if you want to use that. We'll just pause it and get rid of it altogether. Another small change has to do with the App Store. You'll see here where it says get or open, they're now lowercase. So you have the first letter capitalized where it says get, where it was all uppercase before. So if we scroll down, maybe to where it says get here, you'll see that it's different now, where it was uppercase before and lowercase now. If we go into the Tips app, there's a slight change here where if we go to the main screen, it now has setup checklist instead of keep in touch. It's a small change, but it's just the starter screen here as well. Also, we have some new splash screens. So if we go into Safari, within Safari, if we go to private, we now have a splash screen for private browsing. It says private browsing will lock when you leave Safari, leaving private browsing or lock your iPhone. And then it says you can unlock private browsing with Face ID or your passcode. So you can turn it on now or hit not now. It's just a new splash screen that shows up when you run it. Also, the first time I went into the music app on my iPad with iPadOS 17 beta 5, I had a new splash screen. I did not see this on iOS 17 beta 5. Let me know if you saw that though. I wanted to mention a couple other things that aren't relevant to beta 5, but are rather available to everyone now, even on iOS 16.6. If you're using Apple Music, yesterday Apple updated Apple Music with your own station that uses AI that better generates your own station. Then they added an additional discovery station to help find new music. So these are available now. You should see them under recently played. And again, it uses AI to better help find music that's relevant to you. Additionally, they added Apple Pay in Vietnam and also Chile soon. So I mentioned one of those yesterday in my news update with Chile being added. Vietnam should be added as well. So let me know if you're seeing that if you live in either of those countries. Now, as far as the release notes go, let's go into the feedback app. And I'll also post those in the description as it's publicly facing. And if we go in here, you can see there's a bunch of known issues. In fact, there's a couple things to mention with that. There's 77 categories of known issues. That's up from 71 with beta 4 re-release. So lots of different known issues that Apple's still working on. But if you're having issues, make sure you report them in feedback. But check here first to see if you're having those issues that they already know about. So for example, if we scroll down, you'll see there's known issues for accessibility. AirDrop, for example, it says with any classroom class setup, the AirDrop browser on teacher and student devices will not show any device. And then it says on iPad in settings, general AirDrop, a switch is shown labeled bringing devices together. This switch is without function on iPad. So still a few issues that are still there. Again, make sure that you don't have these issues that are listed here if you're going to report them. Additionally, there are 17 categories of resolved issues. So this is a little bit more than last time as well. So go through here. There's new features and more, especially if you're a developer. I'm sure you're familiar with this, but tons of different things that they're aware of that they need to fix before they release it to the public, or at least fix the majority of them. Now, as far as bug fixes that we know of already, well, the stuttering is fixed when swiping away apps. So as you've noticed, as I swipe away, things seem to be fixed. Also, the contacts widget is still working properly. If we go in and just tap on maybe my message here, it brings up your messages right away if you want to do that. And everything seems to be working well. However, there's a couple things that still remain. That notification bug is still here and seems to be, well, that was very slow. So there's definitely some small stutters here and there, very slow here and there, but definitely some issues still going on. Also, I had the phone 100% freeze up on me while I was filming this video earlier. It locked up 100%. I had to do a hard reset to actually get it to come back up. So still a little odd. In general, though, most people are saying performance is quite good. Things seem to be fast when they're working as you would expect, but you get these occasional stutters and hiccups where they just don't go away. But swiping home seems to have fixed that issue, but the notification bug remains. As far as overall heat, well, it is a little bit warm. It was just installed, so it's processing a lot in the background, and we'll check benchmark scores in a little bit, but it definitely seems a little bit warm, but that's probably because it's processing a lot. Now, as far as overall battery is not going to be great. At least it hasn't for me on beta 4. And right now it's really dropping quickly. So if we go down to battery, my battery health is down to 90%. And I did a video earlier in the week talking about that. And if we go to the last 10 days, you'll see I had 3 hours and 36 minutes of screen active time, 33 hours and 48 minutes of screen idle time, and used 100% of my battery and had to charge again. Pretty terrible battery life on beta 4 re-release. Today, I've had 2 hours and 58 minutes of screen active time and used over 50%. So definitely better already, but it will take a few days to measure this. And of course, we'll talk about it in the weekend follow-up as well. Now, as far as if you should install iOS 17 beta 5, if you're worried about bugs or anything else, I wouldn't install the betas. I would wait for the public beta. Let's see how this goes with public beta 3, and we could see that very soon. If you're wondering about public beta 3's release, if we don't have it within a day or so, they may delay it like they did last time and release it next week. But I don't think they'll do that. Typically, they release it within a day or so unless they find major issues. Then they'll do a re-release of beta 5 like they did with beta 4. As far as iOS 17 beta 6's release, I would expect it as soon as the 15th or August 15th next week. Typically, we're on a weekly release schedule at this point, and then we'll have beta 6, beta 7 the following week, maybe a beta 8, and then a release candidate. As long as Apple thinks it's ready to go, we'll get a release candidate and then a final release date. We'll get that at the next event, which many people have said will be on the 12th or 13th of September, which means usually we would have a final release of iOS 17 around the 18th of September. That's what's seeming likely, but Apple could change this, of course, depending on if it's ready or not. We also could see iOS 16.6.1 if Apple needs to fix some issues, or iOS 16.7 RC in early September, with the final release sometime in September as well. That's what we've seen year over year. As far as the overall benchmarks, let's go ahead and take a look at those. I ran it twice as it wasn't great, so let's go ahead and take a look. I took a screenshot of it. I have beta 4 re-release on the left, beta 5 on the right, and when it comes to the single core, it's a little bit better at 2,648 compared to 2,621. However, multi-core is a little bit lower at 5,768 compared to 6,102. This could change over the next few days, and it typically does, and we'll talk about that in the weekend follow-up as well and see if it's improved after it's done processing in the background. But so far, it's a little bit stuttery, and if you're wondering if you should install it, like I said, I probably wouldn't at this point. I would wait maybe until the next beta or just to see how it goes over the next few days. Let me know if you've found anything else, though. I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. And of course, we'll talk about new features on the weekend with that follow-up if we find additional features in this update. Now, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.